Yes, Sunny, you can share your screen. Go ahead.
Thank you, sir. So I'm Sunny. I love to smile and
yeah, I'm smile blessed. Again.
Yeah, so we are all chosen to smile, to be happy that we are alive. And I was talking to one of my students yesterday. She said something so beautiful. She said, "Sir, we not only have the power to smile, but we have power to make others smile." I was so happy. And she's a little girl from Rajasthan. Very simple background, not great English, but the words were full of inspiration. And she proved this quote: the secret of fortune is joy, and it is in our hands. Lot of times I may blame my mother, my father, my sister, or my boss, or my spouse. You're getting to my nerve. You are a villain in my life. They are not villains. Our own mind is a villain. Because if one was a villain, she or he would be villain for all. And remember, if I call someone a villain, I am also villain in their life. So remember, joy is in our hands. So the first few slides are going to reinforce that yes, the joy charger, the key to joy is in our hands. And the door opens from inside. You cannot ask your coach, teacher, parent to study for you, to walk the path for you. Your coach can teach you how to do business, how to live life, but they cannot live your life. But they cannot live life for you. So with these magical thoughts, let us take responsibility to be happy. Happiness does wonders to our health. I may have a 12 o'clock face. I may be upset. But how long? All of us get upset. Even I get upset. I fight. I get angry. But how long? Ask yourself, what is your goal? Peace or happiness? Peace or chaos? Happiness or misery? What is your goal? What is beneficial? Think. It's again and again told to us, yes, happiness is a choice. Let us choose to be happy. This is a very, very empowering statement that I choose to be inspired. I choose to live an inspired life. I choose my emotions. There is a good news here. I can drop hatred. I can drop jealousy. I can drop all my past. I can choose my present. I can choose my future. I am the designer of my life. I am upset right now. It is okay to feel upset, but I can choose an empowered internal state. Yes, happiness is a choice. There are a few repetitions, but let's decide to be happy. And the magical statement comes, it can only come from you. It does not come to you. I may eat dairy milk. I may have the best filter coffee, Kumbakonam coffee, or that mushroom coffee, which is very good for health, which has less caffeine, but it does not last. So in Hindi, they say, when Babaji went to take tea, Babaji said, maja nahi aaya, chai peeke. The chai wala said, maja aata nahi hai, maja lena padta hai. It means happiness doesn't come. You have to create happiness. You have to feel happiness. Right? So it is suited in Hindi only. English, I can't tell the joke. And happiness is a product of being grateful. Yes, I may be repeating gratitude, gratitude, gratitude as the essence for the last 7 days. Yes. Two things I was telling my mother, that there is no happiness without wisdom and giving. Wisdom comes from satsang, reading books. And that wisdom needs to be digested and, you know, applied in service of others. So these two things cannot be ignored. And service can be put as volunteering, whatever, whatever. So this is the essence of happiness. If you can understand this, nothing like it. So let's accept, be grateful, and celebrate life. Then happiness is automatic. And I was also telling one of my friends yesterday, all of us are oceans of happiness. We are manufacturers of happiness. We are creators of happiness. Our happiness will never, never, never end. And we are givers of happiness. So means what? When you call me up, hey, 24 hours, there is a joy. There is an element of enthusiasm. There is an element of gratitude. Right? So let's share it with the world. So decision. I may say you are beautiful, but if you don't accept it, if you don't believe it, if you don't decide to act upon with the compliment given, nothing will change. So you have to decide that you are the luckiest on the planet in the history ever. You have to decide that you are infinite, immortal, eternal, powerful, amazing, beautiful soul. That is the decision we have to make. We have to make a decision to build ourselves. Very important. Yesterday, there was a 1 hour session on just walking the talk. I may talk 10 things. Yes, I will fail in 9, but I need to walk the talk at least in 1. And if I really want to become successful, the top 1% in the world, then I need to walk the talk 10 on 10. I need to build myself. I need to recognize, accept my false, where there is a gap. All of us know a lot of things. All of us talk a lot of things. But do we walk the talk? Right? So that's the journey. Enjoy the false. Get up. Walk again. So this is one of my new beautiful learning, that happiness should be the standard approach. It should be the foundation. There is no compromise. There is no other choice. Because a sad face will not win interviews. A sad face will not win relationships. So happiness is a quantity you want. Happiness is a quantity you decide to be. So be the happiest. And pray for everyone to be the happiest. And tell God, let everyone be happy. And in that prayer, your name will be on top of the list. God will not forget you. Right? So happiness is easy. You have to just decide. If you say anything is difficult, yes, it is difficult. If you say it is easy, it is easy. And if you say it is automatic, it is automatic. Because nature is working. Whole universe is working. It is making it happen. Right? So it's simple and easy, you know. Give comfort, play, support, fun, relief, happiness. So life is easy, you see. Automatic, see, don't have to play. It's a ready-made GIF. Happiness isn't small things. Happiness isn't daily things. When I take baths, the water flows. And for fat people, from the belly, it goes down. Then we have to put another mug of water on our legs. Yes. That water trickling down is joy. Brushing our teeth is joy. But are we aware or are we mechanical? Machine-like, buffalo-like, push. Grr, grr. We a lot of times, you know, pushing our lives. We don't even know. five dosas went inside. We didn't even feel with the five seconds. The speed of eating is so much. Yeah. Phatak, phatak, phatak. And sir, and you know, Shakti, Dr. Saab, you know, they say, eat slowly, mindfully. Bite nicely, chew nicely. Let saliva go inside. I'm a fast eater, impatient. I'm learning patience. I'm giving some positive signals. I'm learning. Sometimes I'm mindful. Sometimes I enjoy. Because I remember these lessons. But the magic is in living, experiencing small little things. Just open your arms. An open body language. These kind of poses. It does wonders. Otherwise, there are headaches even for 10-year-olds. Think we can do a lot. Small things. Spend time with elderly. Sir showed a beautiful video. Small things. Smile. Somebody said, smile whole day as though Lord is clicking your photograph. Smile all day as though the Lord is watching you. Small things can make a big impact. Spend time with kids if there are in your house. Else, pick up from your neighborhood. Call up. Pick up from your relatives. Call up. Today there is video call. Just say, hi, what are you doing? They will come up with some wisdom, some comedy answer. Otherwise, they will test your ego. Right? So let us dare to act. Let us dare to perform. Let us dare to follow. Let us dare to live. You know, when we say dare, you also feel, yes, we need to dare to be happy, to smile, and just go for it. We should have the urgency to work on ourselves. We should have the urgency to be the happiest, to drop all the negative hatred, jealousy, comparisons, greed. Go for it. Don't take slowly, slowly. You know, in Corona, when they give medicines, first 2 days they give 2,000, 3,000 mg medicines. Tha, took. Not 2.5 mg, not 0.5 mg. Right? So, excellence in performance. How will we get? Because excellence is God. Doing your duty is God. Doing your duty is greatness. It is not just becoming famous or having two bungalows or a few thousand crores, right? So excellence comes with these things, right? First is acceptance. Second, intelligence. Third, patience. Fourth, efficiency. Fifth, attitude. But how? Let's see one by one. Now, if I don't do the best, I am not happy. I can't just be lazy and leave the rest. God will do, God will do, God will do. I have to do some work. So now what? Do the best and then leave the rest. Do the best and then there is acceptance. When we accept people as they are, there is peace. when we accept situations, we are solution focused, we are strategy focused, we move ahead in life. When we accept things, we start finding ways to make the best use possible. Think. So acceptance not just works in spirituality, acceptance works in work life. Acceptance brings excellence. Now, if I don't accept, what will happen? There will be confusion. There will be disturbance in my mind. And where there is disturbance, there is poor performance. There are mistakes. There are poor relationships. So acceptance calms our mind. Acceptance can eliminate all the stress. If I accept corona, if I accept death, if I accept the behavior of my kids, you know, the challenges I face with my spouse, in-laws, and I convert it into love, then my tone will change, my BP will be okay, and my HB will go up, and I'll become more efficient. You see, so beautiful, what lovely creativity people have used, I've only copied. Just below acceptance was ocean of peace. No acceptance, no peace. K-N-O-W also works. N-O also works. How beautiful, na? No acceptance, no peace. No acceptance, no peace. Now, acting intelligently. Sir gives a beautiful definition from Wikipedia that intelligence is creating a product or solving a problem. Marx is not intelligence. Rote learning is not intelligence. Learning and vomiting is not intelligence. Reproduction is not intelligence. Reproduction of not babies, reproduction of the knowledge in the exam paper. Right? So, acting intelligently, achieving positively, larger good. So that is possible when mind is calm. But you tell me, what do we do to make our mind calm? What do we do to make our mind focused? What do we do to make our children calm and focused? We are addicted to mobiles. Our children are also addicted to mobiles. Mobiles, the pictures are changing so fast. Where is the calm? And remember, calm is always cool. So intellectual clarity alone can lead to right decisions. Otherwise, if we are not clear where we have to go, why we have to go, how we have to go, then our decisions go wrong, and then the results also go wrong. And then there is a long cut. So let us be dynamic, but have the support of mentors, have the support of right people, experts, so that we live intelligently. Now, how do I be intelligent? How do I use my brain? How should my brain be so active? And should it be active only in talking or in visuals, in fine motor skills, gross motor skills, some fun, some recreation, like Midna Global's beautiful slide, balancing left brain and balancing right brain, balancing work life, balancing family life. That's the mission of Midna Global, and it does it so beautifully. It helps you succeed, but does not drop satisfaction. It helps you become excellent, but does not leave the fulfillment behind. So it gives you, gifts you best of both worlds, the inner world and the outer world. Family and harmony, money and work. What more do we want? It also teaches us, nurtures our brain to live a holistic life. That's important. Let's focus on whole brain. Knowing this 3D gadget brain, and it's just a 15-hour course. And my sincere prayer is, whether you learn for earning, whether you learn for earning, learning or earning, life should transform after this 15-hour training. Means what? You gain awareness and acceptance like this, because you come to know you are living your default design, and you allow others to live their default design. And trust me, when we stop trying to change others, there is nothing but peace. Ratna Swami sir should change, Tyagarajan ji should change, Bhartika Sharma should change, everybody should change. For me, according to me, this attitude will make me the most miserable person in the world, and I will have gold medal in being miserable. So the next point, to be excellence, to live excellence, is patience and perseverance. How is my attitude while waiting? Do I accept what comes? Am I striving hard, or have I given up? Yeah, I am patient, you know, but I am not working hard also. Am I motivated? Am I steady? Am I consistent? Albert Einstein says, be consistent, be busy, be hardworking. So no acceptance, no patience. Even smallest failure will be like a disaster, crisis, and there'll be heavy stress. And we have seen so many people panicking. And great CEOs and chairmen, they talk less, they are strong, they don't get disturbed by small things. And you go to any elderly, most of them who have lived life intelligently, they solve problems just like that. And all of us admire that quality. Why not admire that in yourself? Why not save that inner energy without panicking? Right? I'm learning this art. And we all know, baby will come in 9 months. 3, 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, right? No matter what you do, just live with love. Forgive everyone. Be friends again. So do your best or be the best. Excellence is God. Means what? Whatever you do should be just your 100%. No comparisons. Ratna Swami sir is a great speaker. Fantastic. Should I compare? No. I am giving my best. This is joy for me. I am giving my best in PowerPoint presentations. Aha! Yes, I have prepared 6 presentations so far. Isn't it joy for me? And the day one, I was not roaring. By God's grace, now I am roaring. Little back to form. So should I not celebrate? Doing best will free you from the result. Whether there is 100 audience or 1,000 audience, whether there is local audience or international audience, it does not matter. Because doing best is equal to joy, doing best is equal to satisfaction. Right? So there are great masters who have said, success is not in the trophy won, but is in the race run. True sportsman enjoys the sport, not just the score. And then we are all learning to be good losers in the right spirit. My sister's daughter, my nephew, she told me, Mamu, be a good loser. Lose with a smile. Always want to win. Why? It's okay. What will happen if you lose? No. And you know, we play that property game and all. We're not going to build property in Canada. So what does it matter if we lose? No. But cheating is definitely sorrow. Undoubtedly sorrow. So I may steal Tyagarajan ji's money, Midna Global's assets. I will not get sleep. And I may enjoy for 1 day, 2 days. How many days? Should I run out of the country? Should I go to court again and again? Think. And there are no failures. There are only lessons. There's only redirection. There's only strengthening. There's only training. So they say in NLP, there are no failures, only feedback. So this is one of the ground rules which keeps us going. So we learn to face failure also. So do your best is equal to joy of your life, joy for life. Aspiring to do your best, to fulfill our own potential, is itself empowering. So you want to be empowered? Just do your best. Do a little more. Nature will not leave us. Nature will always love us. When nature can take care of the little ants and beings, and below the boulder also, you know, there's a worm, and you know, the worm has a grain in its mouth. Will it leave you? And think, elephant has to get the food, ant has to get the food. Who should worry? Ant, elephant, or God? Answer is simple. Common sense. God should worry. Why should you worry? You will get whatever you want. In Hindi, they say, whatever is required, jo bhi is shareer ko chahiye, asman phatke bhi aayega. Means, whatever is required for this body, 5 feet, this mortal body, the sky will tear it and, you know, throw it in your lap. So it will fall on your lap. Automatic. So we were talking about failure. Failure is humility. Failure is strength. Failure is preparing us for future challenges. And it is not sometimes. I would say, whatever is happening is the best thing. Everything is the best thing. If we can live in this faith, then there is magic and there is no depression, no dejection, and no anxiety. One disciple went to the master and asked, I'm worried about my future. I'm afraid of my future. The master smiled and the master said, whatever comes, it is acceptable to me. Means what? This power, this magic of acceptance. that whatever happens, whatever God does, whatever God gives in future is fine to me. Means there is no more fear. There is no more anxiety. There is no more uncertainty. Because whatever the Lord gives, it is a gift, it is a prasad. And prasad, you enjoy. Prasad, you accept it with gratitude. So greatness is always in the ordinary. Everybody need not become Obama or Narendra Modi ji. You need not become PM or Abdul Kalam ji, a great scientist. But living your life joyfully, doing your best. That is the measure of greatness. Right? Living your life with values. That is the magic. So you are all great wherever you are today. You all can be great wherever you are placed today. Whichever role you are given, just do it honestly. That makes you great. Do it well. Do it for larger good. Do it beyond self. Do it with a smile. Midna Global helps us find our natural temperaments. It answers two important questions. What am I and what can I? And you see, scriptures have declared that greatness is aligning your work, aligning your daily life with natural temperament. That's what is Midna Global for you. It's a beautiful community with magic, with wonders. And this is not a copied statement for Midna Global. It just happened to flow as part of the topic, greatness in ordinary. So once we live our truest potential with our match of personality, what Sir showed in the video in the beginning, I think our life is going to be filled with greatness. Every day, we don't have to search for happiness. We don't have to run after greatness. The greatness will run after us. And values. Character determines our greatness, not the bank balance. Not what we do, but how we do. How well we play the game, and do we play it well? With true sportsman spirit. Think. This is something we should earn it. Earn it with your smile. Earn it with your deeds. And earn it even with your thoughts. Good intentions. Like Vivekananda ji says, have good feeling. Let everyone succeed. Let everyone become great. Let everyone become peaceful. Let everybody's business go up. Let my competitor earn crores. What is the problem there? Think. If he earns crores, you think I will be left out? The market will go up. I will get my share. And I can eat two rotis in a few lakhs, in a few thousands. Think. So let everyone blossom. Let my community, let my business partners, let my colleagues have more salary than me. I know it is easier said than done. But we need to think. We need to reflect. We need to introspect. Do we dare to say this? So God sent us for a special purpose. Are you living it? So let's make a personal effort to have a personal relationship. With whom? With God. This is bhakti. This is surrender. This is ease. This is faith. This is hope. This is the magic. And see, now this is not made by me, but made by some wise. I only copied it. So think, if you don't want sorrow, this is one easy way. The best relationship we can have is relationship with God. So discover the magic of faith. And I'm not telling this. You see, we already have these ready-made answers. That it keeps us going, it makes us strong. So we have to be discoverers, explorers, right? So let us recognize all the gifts. Let us do our actions for God. And then we can say, whatever comes, 1,000, 2,000, 5,000, 5 lakhs, 5 crores, it's all yours. Then we will not be worried, I failed, I succeeded. No, it is God's will. It is God's work. It is God's results. So I'll be celebrating with a smile. I'm doing the job or when I'm receiving the results. I'll be equanimous. I will go beyond success and failure. I will go beyond the pairs of opposites. I will go beyond the drama of life. Because there are ups and downs. The nature of nature is like that. That there will be rain and sunlight. So that we have rainbow. So finite world is finite joy. If you enter the infinite God's kingdom with relationship with Him, then there is infinite fulfillment because you have an infinite goal. Like Sir says, beyond lifetime, whether we see it or not. So those are infinite goals. Goals of service, right? So go for infinite. There are only positive, 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 magical words here. And you can just feel the slide. Take screenshot if you want. Then I will move ahead because I have one more or two more slides. So the ultimate secret is give your love to the highest. One second. Do everything for Him and let Him work through us. So that is the magic, and all success and failure belongs to God. So life is a celebration. Give all love to God and let Him work through us. His power, His strength comes to us. And we'll be free from all the pinpricks, little storms, and we will explode and be volcanoes and be thunderbolts of love in the world. Thank you. And over to some powerful answers, powerful takeaways, what you have taken from this session. Tyagarajan ji, Bhartika ma'am, if she is there still. So any answers, any feedback? I can see the chat box.
Yes. Hello, Sunny ji. Good morning.
Namaste, ma'am.
Namaste. Yes, very nice session, though I entered late, but I was, you know, could relate so many things with me that no mediator should be there in between God and you.
Wow.
Many times I just, you know, experienced it. That yes, very true. Nobody is needed. No Pandit, no Maulvi, no scriptures. Nobody is needed when you are just sitting with closed eyes and you are inside and you are there. So beautiful. I just liked that sentence and slide. And thank you. Thank you for the wonderful insight. Good
day. Thank you, Pankaj ma'am. And that was actually the magic of sir. They do it at 5 o'clock every day. Super brain.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
They just breathe and, you know, activate all the brain lobes. I'm going to be there soon. Who else is going to share? I see Kritika ma'am sharing only in the chat. She must open up and, you know, share it in voice. Beautiful words and insights is good, but which word was beautiful? Which insight was beautiful? You know, I'm a teacher of that kind only. All of you understood? Yes, sir, understood. What was good? Everything was good, but we don't know what has.
Sir, happiness is our choice and it's our decision. That was fantastic. Yeah, time and again, making it run in my mind. It's our decision. There is no external force that is giving us that happiness. Good. Yeah, it's a decision taken by us. Absolutely right. Every now and then, we need to keep on, you know, reinforcing ourselves with these words. And as you said, walk the dog.
Amma, I'm sure you will be the happiest on the planet because this realization is not easy. And telling this is not easy.
I was able to just go through that again and again, though other slides were coming. This was the one we said, yeah, it's a conscious decision one takes. Do we have a choice? That was a very good point.
Yeah. And actually, you don't have a choice. You should promise me to smile whole day without changing your face.
Correct.
A big smile. And there will be moments. Yes. I will not disagree that... Yeah. Yeah, our face changes. Sir not giving me some incentive. Sir scolding me. Sir not appreciating. Sir straight away telling, okay, we go to the next session. So sometimes all that will happen. But then bounce back. I choose to be happy again. Okay. I don't drag it for days and months and years.
Yeah. At what cost? Yeah.
So it should be like time bomb, you know. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bounce back. 5 seconds is too much, no? 3, 2, 1, I'm back. Because my heart is feeling, you know. Ay-ay-yo. Let's come back to aha.
Yeah, correct. See, all these challenges that we face, which are only preparing ourselves for a better days and better future. Yeah, it is giving us some, you know, indication that there's something that needs to be changed.
Okay, Amma, I'll tell you one thing.
Yeah.
How many kids do you have?
2 grown-up boys.
Very good, Amma. Now you tell me, will you give them pain?
Not consciously, definitely.
Puridilla. Appo kadavaliya ungalku kashtam kudupaaru. Neenga enna sonninga? Ayyo, challenges kudukkaraaru.
I didn't say that. I said, whatever challenges that
we go through. One second, I'll just tell this in English, then you speak.
Yeah.
So, when a mortal mother, 5 feet mother, does not give pain to children, why will the almighty loving Lord give us pain and challenges?
Yeah.
And even if he gives, he'll be watching, facilitating, helping, protecting, loving, and he'll only be giving positive things.
Correct. Whatever is needed for us, that's what I meant.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Yeah.
This magic, God loves us unlimited.
Yes. No doubts.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you. God bless you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Now, sir roars.
Yeah, like some participants say, you have said everything, sir. I have nothing to say. Like that, like that also I can wind up the session. But I personally look at this in a slightly different way. That is, the production of certain neurochemicals in our brain is what we call happiness. Okay. And there are different neurochemicals, and out of which dopamine is supposed to be the wow hormone. The minute you achieve something, get something, you get a feeling, yeah, I have achieved something. It's a kind of rewarding and sense of achievement. I would say it's an ego booster. So dopamines are giving, becoming the ego boosters to human beings. And the levels raise for various reasons. Okay, the dopamine is increased, levels raise for various reasons. Because the different quantities are produced from different sources, the initiating root cause effect, or the root for which the dopamine is increased, is very, very important in my opinion. But I think most of the time we are all interlinking or maybe casually addressing all of them in one word called happiness. But I guess that's all right for a general audience and to tell it to begin with. But I think as a brain profiling experts, that we all go through a little in-depth understanding of the brain, we need to really understand why certain people are not able to be very happy, and then what they have to do or what they can think of doing or what they should practice to motivate themselves to become a reason for the rise of dopamines. So there are four major neurochemicals called DOSE, oxytocin, serotonin, endorphins, and dopamines. So we'll just talk about dopamines for a few minutes and we will wind up this session. And the dopamines can be raised because of a physical aspect.